Today we are going to 17th day class from economics lesson 1, money, savings and investment. Yesterday class I taught you what is the meaning of money, savings and investment. Okay, before itself we are going to discuss the worksheet. Before class is yesterday class worksheet. Okay, in this pattern they ask question, choose the correct answer pattern, and second another important one, they ask choose the correct answer. Choose the correct statement. They given totally 4 statement. That 4 statement itself, you choose which one are correct statement. Suppose 4 statement, 1, 2, 3, 4 they given. In that you choose a correct statement, 1, 3 are correct, 1, 2 are correct, 1, 2, 4 are correct. Like that they ask answer. But you read the answer carefully and choose the correct statement and the correct answer. Okay. And second, they ask the question in there, fill in the blanks. Next, Roman number 3, match the following. And Roman number 4, answer in brief. Okay. Right. First, we are going to discuss, choose the correct answer. Right. First question, which metals were used for metal money? Which metals were used for metal money? You know kinds of money, that is commodity money, metal money, paper money, credit money, near money. Like that you yesterday class you saw title. But in that we ask question, which metals were used for metal money? Answer is A, gold, B, silver, C, bronze, and D, all the above. I told you in the class yesterday, 3 metals also they utilized to make coins. Okay, after the barter system, exchange for goods, goods for goods, exchanging goods for goods, they used barter system afterwards. What they used? Metals are used to make coins. Okay, right. So here, gold, silver, bronze, and D option, all the above they given. Answer is D, all the above. They used to make coins, 3 type of metals, gold, silver and bronze. Okay, so answer is D, all the above. And second question, money is derived from das word. Money, that is derived, already I told you, what word? A, Roman number. A, Roman. B, Greek. C, Latin. D, Sanskrit. Answer is A, Roman. Answer is A, Roman. Okay. And third question, choose the correct statement. First question they given, the barter system had many deficiencies like that. The barter system had many deficiencies like, before it's an earliest period, the people of the world, they used barter system. What is barter system? Exchange goods for goods, known as a barter system. Okay. So the barter system has had many deficiencies. That means many disadvantages. In that they given which one is correct, you choose and write the answer. First one, lack of double coin sidings of wants. Second, no difficulties of storing wealth. And third, common measure of value. And fourth, indivisibility of commodity. This four answer they given. In the which one answers are correct? First, lack of double counting, double coincidence of wants. Correct answer. First one is correct. Then no difficulties of storing wealth. This is you know about the wrong. Okay. Then common measure of value. Value is common measure. Okay. And this answer correct. First one correct, third one correct, second one wrong. But the difficulties of storing wealth answer. But here they given no difficulties of storing wealth. So first one correct, second one wrong, third one correct, and fourth one indivisibility of commodity. They given answer. Okay, so fourth one is also correct. In 4 answer, which or answer are correct? First and third and fourth. So here they given absent answer. First A, 1 and 2 is correct. B, 1 and 4 is correct. C, 1, 3 and 4 are correct. D, all are correct. They given. But here we read the answer is 1, 3 and 4 are
option 1, 3 and 4 are correct. Okay. Next, Roman number 2nd Phyllis. Okay. The Indian rupee is derived from dash word. Indian rupee derived from which word? Before itself, we utilize what type of language in India? Sanskrit language. What type of language? Sanskrit. So, in the Indian rupee is derived from which word? Sanskrit word. Answer. You know about that? That is rupiya. 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 R-U-P-Y-A. R-U-P-Y-A. Rupiya means silver coin. In that also, we know about it. Sanskrit and Hindi also derived rupiya. Rupiya means silver coin. Okay. Right. The Indian rupee is derived from that word, Sanskrit word. Answer. Next, fifth question. Exchange of goods was known as dash. First itself, we read about this. Okay. Exchange of goods was known as, goods for goods exchange, known as barter system. What's the answer? Barter system. Sixth question. Commodity money changed into dash money. You know what after commodity means? Exchange goods for goods known as barter system. Commodity money also another name known as barter system. Okay. So this human being on the world, in the world, they developed step by step and they progress their civilization. Then after they change the commodity money into metal money. What money? Metal money. So commodity money changed into dash money, metallic money. Answer is metallic money. Right. Roman number 3rd, match the following. Already I informed you. Match the following writing time. You write first A side all questions, then you write B side direct answer. Okay. So A side they given barter system, rupiah, manita zuno. 3 questions they given. B side answer they given 4. Roman verb, Greek word, silver coin, exchange for goods. Exchange goods for goods, the answer given. But here question is barter system. Barter system means you know about answer. Exchange goods for goods. Answer is exchange goods for goods. Right. Next question 8-1. Rupiah, that word. What is the meaning of rupiah? I told you, rupiah means silver coin. Rupiah means silver coin. Next, manita juno. What is the meaning? What is the word? This word derived from Roman word. First itself they given in this lesson. Manita juno, Roman word. This only derived. Which one answer? Money. Money. That means manita juno is a Roman word, not a Greek word or Sanskrit word. Roman word. So barter system exchange goods for goods. Rupiah, silver coin. Manita juno, answer is Roman word. Next to Roman number 4. Roman number 4, answer the following questions. Okay. Our answer in brief. What is money? They given first question answer. What is money? Money means, first you write the heading. Question number 10, answer is heading money. Money is anything which is widely accepted in payment for goods or in discharge of other business obligation. Money is anything which is widely accepted in payment for goods or in discharge of other obligation. Who given this definition of money? Robertson. Who was Robertson? Robertson was a professor. Okay. Right. And next question. Barter system. What is barter system? They ask question. You write the heading. Barter system. Right. Barter system is exchanging goods for goods without the use of money. We are not use money. We only exchanging goods. Example, I told you. In South India, rice available. In North India, wheat. Cultivated things. Okay. So we exchange the goods for goods. Rice we given to North India. Wheat they given to South India. Okay. Like that they exchange for goods. Exchange goods for goods is known as barter system. So barter system is exchanging goods for goods without the use of money in the primitive stage, in olden stage, not developed earliest period. So that primitive stage they used barter system. A barter system is an old method of exchange. That is, they followed in old method. Nowadays we can utilize, we know different stages of money they invented. Okay, they discovered. Right. Barter system is exchanging goods for goods without the use of money in the primitive stages. and a barter system is an old method of exchange. And third question, next they ask question, third question, what are the deficiency in barter system? This already asked in choose the correct statement question. Okay, here they ask question, what are the deficiency in the deficiency in barter system? First one is lack of double coincidence of wants. Lack of double coincidence of wants. Second, common measure of value. Common measure of a value. And third one, indivisibility of commodities. And fourth one, difficulties of storing wealth. Fourth one, difficulties of a storing wealth. Okay, we discussed the question pattern worksheet. Question pattern, choose the correct answer. Fill in the blanks, match. And third one, answer in brief, we finish. Okay, right? Are you all clear, the students? Clear answer, students? Now we are going to discuss the lesson. Already you know about it. Introduction about money. Introduction about money. And another title we know about it, evolution of money. Another title we know, we discussed in before classes, evolution. And deficiency of barter system. You know about what is barter system, we discussed. And another important one, some of the major stages money. Okay, that is the different stages we know about the commodity money, metal money, paper money, next near money, then another money also we know about the credit money. Another money, credit money, like that we know about different type of money. In that we know about the first commodity money. Commodity money also you know about the exchange for goods. Exchange goods for goods, that is known as commodity money. Okay, such exchanges like things also for skin, rice, like the wheat, utensils, vessels also be exchanged. Okay, right. Metallic money means with the development stage of the human civilization, they used metals to make coins. Metals to make coins. Okay, so the step by step the human being, commodity money into changed metallic money. That means the human beings utilized metals to make coins. What are the metals they used? Gold, silver, copper, like that metals they used. Why? What purpose they used? This easily handled and also its quantity can be easily find out. Easily handled and the quantity will be, we also quantity can be easily find out. Okay, so this also already in the form of money, in the form of a money. Okay, throughout this mentioned in our historical recorded, historical recorded. Okay, then next we are going to discuss another important title, history of metallic money. What's the history? How the human being, this is not a discuss about it overnight, one day, night, this discuss long years, we told before class, 1000 years they taken to stages of money to discover. Okay, right. First you know about the precious metals they used to make coins, example for gold, silver, copper, bronze. Gold, silver, copper, bronze. What's meaning of bronze? Bronze means alloy of copper and tin. Both also they mixed to create metal. What metal? Bronze metal. Okay. So this given a standard weight and also to over value, great value. Standard weight and also great value. Okay. Of metallic. Okay. Metallic. Particularly they used the metal gold and the silver. Gold and the silver only great value. Great value and also standard weight they utilize. Right. In that they given these metals are standard means they use seal. Seal means you know what is the meaning of seal? A device or substance. A device or substance they used to make seal on the things. Okay, on the metal. So this is called a seal. With a seal. Why? This is for medium of exchange used the metal to make money. To make money. Right. So they but they were different denomination. Denomination means what is the meaning? Different value of money. Gold different value, silver different value, copper different value, bronze different value. So in that day, but easily divisible, easily portable. Portable means easily carried and also to this were convenient in making payments. Easily we can given to payment instead of payments. For money we can given the things. Okay. So easily payment, easily portable. Easily portable means easily carry and also to easily divisible. Okay. But anyway, first who used these metals to make coins in the world. But in your book given first, King Midas of Lydia. King Midas of Lydia. Lydia king. Lydia means Lydia is in a place of Turkey. This is where he is situated in Turkey. The King Midas of Lydia only used metal coin. He only introduced metal coin. He only used the innovated method. That means new method to make coin. That is, he used to make coin with metal. Okay, right. In which century means? In your book given, King Midas of Lydia is in Turkey. Lydia is in Turkey. In the 8th century, he used by whose period? Historical writer Herodotus. This period he invented, he innovated method 8th century. But before itself you used this coins in ancient period. That means by the ancient historians period, he used the innovated method of introduced coin King Midas of Lydia. Okay, right, 8th century. But another important one, but the gold coins and silver coins, that is in India, they used many centuries before Lydia, before in the innovative coins are introduced by the King Midas of Lydia, who used in the 6th century BC itself. Indians first used in ancient period, Indians which coins? Gold and silver coins. After followers, Chinese, next then Lydians. So first in introduced the Indians. Which century? 6th century. Okay. That is example for that period. They introduced the coins name called Puranas. Puranas, Karsapanas. Coins name called Puranas, Karsapanas. Karsapanas, another name called shortly Panas. That is 6th century. After follower, then Chinese. Then Chinese after Indians. Okay. Like then step by step, first ancient period used coins with the Indians, Chinese and Indians. Okay, right. So these people, these three people, people country situated in Middle East. In the world map, you compare first Middle East. Middle part of Turkey. Then next, here East part of the world, India and China. India and China. Okay, so these three people in the Middle East. Next, you know what? The first time Indian coin was minted. Which century we know? 6th century BC. Example for Mahasanapatas. What is Mahasanapadas? A big part of the country was ruled. Country was ruled by Mahasanapadas during period. You studied in 7th standard. 16 Mahasanapadas. In that 16 Mahasanapadas, who ruled? Who dominated? That means Magadha king. Magadha king. Magadha, Kosala, Vatsala. Like that, totally Mahasanapadas period, they utilized Puranas and Karsapanas. Panas, that is coins, gold and silver coins they utilized. After whose period started? The Maurya came up with the punch-marked coins. After that, next followed King Midas, after next Indian, Chinese, Indians, after Maurya period, who used it? The Maurya came up ruled in India, they introduced punch-marked coins. In the metal they used to make coins, silver, gold, copper or lead. Silver, gold, copper or lead. Okay. So next, Maurya after who used the Kushan kings. Kushan kings example for Kanishka was famous ruler. Kanishka was a famous ruler of Kushan Empire. Okay. Kushan Empire period, he used the style of coin Indo-Grey. That means style of India and Greek. You know why? Because under who mostly trade contact with India means Greek people only, okay, Rome people. So the Greek people, so he introduced Kushan period, Kushan king, he introduced Indo-Greek coin, that is custom of coin. Okay, next after another Kushan king afterwards, who used the Turkish Sultan of Delhi. You know about them, the Muslim rulers are invaded India and they ruled India long years, okay. So the Turkish Sultan of Delhi, he used to introduce the silver coin and made the picture status as coin a royal design. Royal design. That means in the royal design they made the pictures Indian kings. Okay. Then the Turkish already the Indian rulers used the Indian kings made the picture of royal designs. But and also used with the Islamic calligraphy. Okay. Then next, 1526, who ruled India? The Mughal period. That means you know what in the year in history very important. The first battle of Panipat. During the who invaded India? Babur. Okay. The last Mughal ruler Ibrahim Lodi. Lodi dynasty. He defeated and captured the power of Delhi. Babur. Okay. During the Mughal period in 1526, they also used to make metals, make coins with the metals. Okay. So like that, what metals they used? Gold, silver, copper, and lead. Okay. Right. Next, the evolution of rupee changed into the evolution of coins changed. They occurred with it during next period, Sersa Suri. Why Sersa Suri came to power in India? After 1526, after Babur.
Gold and making ornaments, they were called goldsmith. Okay, so
the storing of gold they given to the goldsmith means the goldsmith issued a receipt for them. Okay, so the paper money from the stage of developer they storing which one? Gold. So these gold are they given to goldsmith and the goldsmith say receipt. Goldsmith issued a receipt. So this receipt only they changed as money. Okay, changed as money. So the paper money is one of the important regulated and controlled over afterwards. The stages from gold and silver calling next paper money. This controlled and regulated by who in India? Who's in India? That means Central Bank of the country. Central Bank of the country means you know about the Reserve Bank of India. Central Bank of the country means what's the meaning? Reserve Bank of India. So that is very important. Who control and regular over the money? That means paper money. That means Central Bank. Another name known as Reserve Bank of India. Right? At present, very large amount part of money stored. That means very large part of money consists of a mainly currency note. Mainly what they called a currency note or another name called paper money. Paper money, another name called a currency note. Large part of amount consists of a currency note or paper money that is issued by Central Bank. Who issued the money? Paper money or currency note? Central Bank of India or otherwise another name called Reserve Bank of India. Okay, that is paper money over. Okay, next, last after this lesson, we know about different types of countries' currency and the symbol. Okay, right, next we are going to discuss about another one, credit money. Credit money, another name known as bank money. Credit money, another name known as, what is the name? Bank money. Credit money, another name is bank money. That means, what is the meaning of credit? Credit means a way of things buying. A way of things buying and also goods and services from the shop. Okay, and not paying them. We buy goods from the shop, but not paying them until later we pay. That means after buying things, we given card, they easily get money from our account. That is only called later we pay the money for buying things is called credit money. Okay, that means this utilize emergency time. Suppose we example for we are going to shopping in the shop. Okay, we buy most of the things. Say finally we are not enough money, so we need money to buy extra things. Means we utilize from our account number and then they later take an amount from our account. So why? What's the reason? Because we deposited extra money, paper money. The people keep part of their deposit, part of their cash as deposit. So not only use money and also the people cash they deposited, used as deposited with the banks. So who are all use which they can withdraw their money? That means for their convenience. In whenever they need, wherever they need for their convenience, taken money from the bank. So those who are all eligible to take amount from the bank, the customers of the bank, the customers of the bank or financial institution or a financial institution. Right. Next, near money. Next, we are going to discuss near money. Near money is the final stage of the evolution of money. Suppose they ask one question. The final stages of the evolution of money is dash. What's the answer you are going to write? Near money. What is the meaning of near money? This has been a use of bill of exchange. Use of bill of exchange. Sometimes we receive bill after it. Afterwards, they have given the bill means they have given exchanging of goods or things or money, anything. Okay. So bills of exchange. Then treasury. Bills, treasury bills, what's the amount? Treasury means in the funds or revenue of a state is called treasury. In the funds or revenue of a state is called treasury. So that is called treasury bills. And the next, bonds. What is the meaning of bonds? Fixed income we pay instrument. That means fixed income we can utilize to instrument that representative of loan money. Okay, that is called a bond. That is called a bond. And next, debentures. What is the meaning of debentures? That means if we save money as deposit. called saving certificate. With the interest fixed interest, that is called saving certificate. Okay, so these are all called near money in the form of bills. Next, recent forms of money. Next class, next we are going to discuss. Okay, right. Recent forms of money, plastic money, e-money, online banking, e-banking, next title, value of money. Okay, thank you children. Next we are going to discuss next title.